गुड आफ्टरनून चिल्ड्रन, हाउ आर यू? ओके फाइन, थैंक यू। ओके, टुडे वी विल लर्न द लेसन सी रीडिंग इन स्कूल लाइफ। यू हैव गॉन थ्रू ए रीडिंग, Swami is expelled from school and a poem that is not just a teacher but a friend. Have you read these two readings thoroughly? Have you done the exercises, textual exercises? Okay. Very good. You show them to your teacher. Okay. Today, our topic is homework. Do you like homework? No? Why? Why don't you like homework? Okay. It is boring. Okay. So, many of the people don't like to do homework because they feel it is boring and it is some kind of burden. They feel some kind of burden, isn't it? So, homework is not that much bad. There are some useful things and there is a positive side also for homework. Today we will see all these aspects in this lesson, homework. Okay, so I shall introduce myself. I am Amarnath, Scholastant English, ZPHS Chandrapatla in Kallur Mandal of Khammam district. Okay, children? Right. Thank you. I hope you enjoy this lesson. Okay. So, before going into the lesson, we shall learn what is the homework. Okay. What is homework? Homework or a homework assignment is a set of tasks assigned to students by the teachers to be completed outside the class. This work is not intended to do in the class. You have to do outside class. That means you do in the home. Okay? You can do the homework collectively also sometimes. Okay. So, homework may vary. It may be different. It may be reading some kind of textual exercises, textual passages or textual readings, or it may be writing or completing the exercises, or may particular in English, writing discourses. If it is in Telugu, you have to recite the poems, Telugu and Hindi. And if it is in science, you have to do the practicals, or you have to collect some kinds of samples also. Okay. And when it is in social subjects, you have to do the surveys also. All these are homeworks. Okay. You have to write the reports about the projects. Okay. All these are homeworks. Typing a project, and in mathematics you have to do the exercises. Okay. And in maths and science and in social also you have to collect some kind of objects, collecting data. So all these are homeworks. Okay. Now, we shall learn the glossary. First one is reinforce. What do you mean by reinforce? Okay. Reinforce means make a feeling or an idea stronger. ఒక విషయాన్ని దృఢపరచుకోవడం మన మనసులో గట్టిగా నేర్చుకోవడం. సో రీఇన్ఫోర్స్ ఈజ్ ఎసెన్షియల్ ఇన్ రీఇన్ఫోర్స్మెంట్ ఈజ్ ఎసెన్షియల్ లెర్నింగ్. ఓకే చిల్డ్రన్, నెక్స్ట్ కౌంటర్ ప్రొడక్టివ్. వాట్ యు మీన్ బై కౌంటర్ ప్రొడక్టివ్? హ్యావింగ్ ఆపోజిట్ ఎఫెక్ట్ టు ద ఇంటెండెడ్. సో మనం ఏదైతే ఆశించామో దానికి వ్యతిరేకమైన ఫలితం రావడాన్ని కౌంటర్ ప్రొడక్టివ్ అంటాం. సో యు సీ ఇన్ దిస్ పిక్చర్ టూ మెన్ ఆర్ రోయింగ్ ఇన్ ఆపోజిట్ డైరెక్షన్స్. డు దే గెట్ రిజల్ట్? నో, ఆబ్వియస్లీ. ఓకే, సో కౌంటర్ ప్రొడక్టివ్ మీన్స్ గివింగ్ ఆపోజిట్ రిజల్ట్స్. నెక్స్ట్ ఎక్సెసివ్. యు సీ in the picture the lady is consuming a lot of burgers and the man is consuming a lot of water. That means excessive food, excessive water. Okay, that means greater than what seems reasonable. Ati antam telugulo atiga teeskovadam atiga cheyadam ani. ఓకేనా, నెక్స్ట్ విల్ గో టు ద నెక్స్ట్ వర్డ్, సోషల్ లైఫ్. సోషల్ లైఫ్ మీన్స్ ద పార్ట్ ఆఫ్ ఎ పర్సన్స్ టైమ్ స్పెంట్ డూయింగ్ ఎంజాయబుల్ థింగ్స్ విత్ అదర్స్ లైక్ ప్లేయింగ్, లైక్ షాటింగ్ అండ్ లైటింగ్, లైక్ so example, I joined the club to improve my social life. In social life they enjoy. Okay, right, we'll go to the next word, dates. Here in our lesson, dates means exists, something exists, that means undatam. ఓకే, ఎప్పటి నుంచో ఉంది అన్న అర్థంలో. ఓకే, రైట్. నెక్స్ట్ వర్డ్ ఈజ్ ఇన్సెంటివ్. ఇన్సెంటివ్ మీన్స్ సంథింగ్ దట్ ఎంకరేజెస్ ఎ పర్సన్ టు డూ సంథింగ్, లైక్ ఇఫ్ యు డూ దిస్ ఐ విల్ గివ్ దిస్ వన్. యు సీ ఇన్ ద పిక్చర్ ద మ్యాన్ ఈజ్ గివింగ్ ఎ క్యారెట్ టు ద పీపుల్. దట్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ rewarding, like rewards. Okay, so incentive. Okay, your mother may say sometimes if you do your homework I will give you a chocolate, so that is an incentive also. Okay, right. Curriculum. What do you mean by curriculum? The subjects that are included in a course of study. So if you are studying 9th class and you are going to school, and this has a lot of subjects, and this has some games like that, all these are called curriculum. Okay, right. Backpack related injuries. So in this picture the injuries caused by heavy bags. So our topic is homework, and it is related to our baggage also. When our baggage increases, it weighs more, our spinal cords bends more, and that leads to injuries also, chronic injuries also. It may lead to severe health problems also. Okay, you have to keep that in mind. I will explain it later. Okay, curricular activities and extra curricular activities. I want to differentiate few things between few differences between these curricular and extracurricular activities. So curricular activities means reading textbooks, writing notebooks, reciting poems, reciting tables in mathematics, reciting equations in science and maths, and appearing for examinations, and getting results, and promoting to next class. All these things are related to curricular activities. But what are extracurricular activities? The activities which you are enjoying, you do with enjoyment, these are called extracurricular activities. Don't you play and enjoy? Yes, you play. You play and enjoy. Every student want to go and go out and play. Sir, these are leisure periods, sir. Shall we go out and play, sir? Every student asks sir, their teacher. Why? Because they enjoy. Because you enjoy. Okay. And participating in sports events and listening or playing music or singing songs and going to picnics, going to educational tours, dancing for songs in various occasions, in picnic also, in annual day also. Some people used to dance and enjoy. Some people used to draw and some people used to paint. So all these are called extracurricular activities. These activities are also included in our school events. Okay. So these are called extracurricular activities. Right? Right. So we will go to the lesson now. Children, you open your textbook and read the lesson. Okay. I will read out it for you. You open your textbook and follow me. Okay. Right. Homework has historically been given to students to reinforce what they learn at school and ultimately help them learn the material better. Okay. So here the author is telling that homework is intended to reinforce what they learn. You know the meaning of reinforce means strengthen. We have to strengthen the ideas what we have learned in the school so that we won't forget it. So that is the ultimate aim or goal of the giving homework or doing homework. Okay, right, children? But however, too much homework is not helpful and it can be counterproductive. You learn. The meaning of the counterproductive, that is, that gives opposite results. Too much homework gives opposite results. Why? Why? You know, too much, when you have too much homework, you get bored. You lose interest in it. Okay. You want to go away from the homework. And when the child didn't done homework, he plans to escape absent for the school next day to face the teacher. Okay, so it will be counterproductive if the homework is given too much. Right. Excessive amounts of time spent on completing homework can take away the kid's social life, family time, and it limits their participation in sports and other activities also. Okay, right, children? Kids want to enjoy. They want to see movies in the TVs and they want to watch some other cricket matches or they want to play with their friends after school time. But this homework restricts them from all these activities. And some children may not spend time with their family also. So excessive amount of time, excessive amount of homework is not helpful for the students. Right, children? The amount of homework a teacher has to give to a student should be restricted. Okay? Should be restricted. It should be moderate. It should be minimized. Okay. If Telugu teacher, English teacher, Hindi teacher, and every subject teacher has given homework in all seven subjects, it will be heavy homework to the students, and he may lose the interest in academics. Okay. Next para. Critically acclaimed author Tamim Ansari reports that since 1981, the amount of homework given to an average sixth class child has increased by more than 50%. You see, so Tamim Ansari, he is a well-known author. You see his picture here. Yes, he is. He is Tamim Ansari. He is a well-known author. He says that for 6th class student, not a 10th class student or 9th class student, for the 6th class student from 1981 to 2015 or 2012, in 30 years of the span, the amount of the homework increased 50%. You know, you see. So why the amount of homework is increases? Because we will see later the reason why it is. Many people claim that the increase in homework dates as far back as 1957. From 1957 itself, the homework is given to the students. The trend was begun there in 1957 itself. Okay. The new competition that served as an incentive for schools to try to increase the value of the curriculum. So, why the amount of homework is increasing? Because there is a competition. Competition is emerging. Everybody is studying. Everybody want to get jobs, and when everybody want to learn things and everybody wants one thing, the competition increases, and and the other thing is the volume of curriculum also increased. You know, curriculum means the subjects in a school. Okay, what we are learning is curriculum. The volume of the curriculum is increasing. When the volume of curriculum is increasing, definitely the amount of homework also increases. When the amount of the volume increases, the child has less time to do other works. Every time he has to do the homework. Okay. The amount of homework increases with the increase in class. That is also true. So when you have to do some homework in 6th class, when you go to 7th class, the amount will increase. You have to do more homework. You are now you are studying 9th class. Next year you will go to 10th class. There you have to do a lot of homework, isn't it? So when class increases, your homework also increases, right? Go to the next para. Many teachers defend large amounts of homework, claiming that it helps to prepare students for a world that is becoming increasingly competitive. So many teachers wants to give loads and loads of homework to the students so that they can prepare for the future. They can learn many things. They hope that the teachers hope to learn, that the child will learn many things by doing homework. Okay. However, Dr. Kralovec, author of The End of Homework, argues that doing homework during high schools has little or no effect on successful study skills of the students when they join college. Okay, you see on the picture, she is Dr. Kralovec. She has written a book that is named The End of Homework. You see, so this is such a big topic, she has written a whole book. Okay, so The End of Homework, that means is she encouraging homework or she discouraging homework? Yes, she is discouraging giving homework. She is telling that there is no use in doing homework, or very, very less use in doing homework. So when the usage, when it is not useful, why you are giving a lot, tons of homework to the children, and why you are suffering the children? She is asking. Okay, you go to the next para. Excessive amounts of homework can be harmful to kids, both physically and mentally. Yes. Physically, they have to carry loads of luggage, and they have to strain their bodies, their minds, and they have to write lots of pages, notebooks. That is physical harmfulness. Physically, they are tiring. And mentally also, it gives stress to the students. Oh, there is a lot of work, homework I have to do today, or the teacher will ask me. Okay, so here you see lot of baggage. Excessive amount of homework can be harmful to kids, both physically and mentally. A lot of homework usually means a lot of books to carry. Okay, here the child is carrying a lot of books. 55% of Massachusetts, an institution in the USA, that means America, children, as per the survey by researchers of Simon's College, carry loads heavier than 15% of their body weight, which is the suggested limit. So what is the suggested limit? If the child is 50 kgs, he has to carry only 7.5 kg baggage. But it is not implementing. The child has to carry the child has to carry heavier than this limit. So what happens? Which is suggested limit? Carrying luggage amounts of weight daily at a young age can do a lot of damage because bones are still in development stage. So when a child carries heavy baggage, what happens? There is a lot of problems because it is a tender age, and their bones are growing, and their spinal cord is growing. In this situation, this heavy luggage will impact his growth. The U.S. Consumer Product Safety Commission has reported that in 1999, more than 800 kids were treated in emergency wards for backpack-related injuries. As you are learned earlier, 800 people in a single year, they are treated with backpack-related injuries. How pity it is. Okay. Many of these injuries can lead to serious problems later in life, including chronic shoulder pain, neck pain, and back pain. These injuries not only resulting now, but after they grown, when they grown-ups, they feel pains in shoulder and neck and back. Okay, so this is very, very very So this is a kind of situation we have to look into that. Okay. So you see here the child is frightening by the heavy homework. Okay. Right. And beware of the backpack. You have to take some precautions while you are carrying your baggage. You see here the students are doing their homework in the school bus itself because they have no time, so they are doing the homework in the bus itself. Okay. Next, yes, this kid is also doing the homework in the bus because there is no time. Yes, here you see the boy is carrying baggage, heavy bag. This is the wrong position. First one is the wrong position and second one is the right position. You have to carry baggage like this. Okay. No bag day. We will learn this about in the next lesson. Students, we will stop this lesson today and we will continue it day after tomorrow. So, homework is useful only when it is minimized and it is optimum homework is given to the children. That is our lesson. With this, I will conclude it. So, I don't give any homework today. Okay? But you come by reading this lesson thoroughly on day after tomorrow, same time. Okay? Thank you. Thank you very much.